Hi everybody, it's Claire. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are in my living room. I feel like I haven't talked to the camera in, well, the last two videos, and a lot of you guys said you really liked that, so I'm like, do I not talk as much anymore? I can't not talk to you guys. I don't want that disconnection feeling. We're gonna do a haul today, and it's gonna be makeup and fashion products. I thought it'd be kind of fun to do both. If you're here usually for makeup, I'll do that first so that you guys can leave if you really want. The fashion items are really good, I'm telling you. I'm gonna get right into it because I don't wanna bore you guys. I already feel like I'm chatting too much. I didn't even have any caffeine today. I gave up caffeine. I think I've just been alone today. First and foremost, Camera Ready Cosmetics. I'm following up from a haul I did recently for my makeup artist kit. If you guys know, I'm a freelance makeup artist in the DC area, and I'm always buying stuff for my kit, like unhealthy amounts for my kit. I try not to, but there are essentials that I replenish, and one of them is this Cinema Secret makeup brush cleaner, and it smells like vanilla. You need it in your life. It's this amazing bright blue color that I just love. It's so good. I actually put some of it in a spray bottle because I try to conserve it because I just love it so much. And that is a tip for you guys, to put your makeup brush cleaners, if they come like this, in a spray bottle. So you spray into the paper towel, clean out your brush. It's amazing. Honestly, one of the best, like, so many makeup artists I know swear by it because it just does such a good job, and it's quick drying. So you don't need any, if you're not a makeup artist, you could still use it. And they have it at Sephora now. But I love Camera Ready Cosmetics because you get the discount. So that's crucial. So the other thing that I wanted to talk about from Camera Ready Cosmetics is, I think you guys saw that I bought this Fusette Tahiti palette, which is the 24 shade palette that I can't believe I did it. You guys, I actually sat down and like, every single lipstick that I had that was nude, I like did a whole paper towel swatch thing. It was a process. Like, girls who say that this is like enjoyable, I mean, I don't know, we come from different planets, because this was so not enjoyable for me until the end, when I was like, oh my God, I'm done, and I can like have everything in one place. So definitely worth the annoying time like that it took to cut out all my lipsticks, but definitely not the most fun thing in the world. I had a huge glass of wine while I did this, and that's the only thing that got me through. But this is gonna be amazing, and I'm actually going to do this for my bold lipstick shades that I have as well. If you guys wanna see that, which actually you guys requested on Instagram, so, and I'm listening to you guys, I read all your comments, I'm gonna do that for you guys. So look out for that. I'm gonna show you how I depot all of them, but it's really easy. All you do is chop out the lipstick and smear it in, but I'm gonna show you guys because I feel like some of you guys were like really getting excited by how this looks. It said it looks like ice cream, so I like that. But so yeah, that was also from Camera Ready Cosmetics. And then I'm now looking at my table. I'm like, there was something else, but I don't see it. Nothing's processing. Okay. Oh my gosh. Okay. It's right in front of me. So it's the biggest thing on the table. It's this blush palette, and I got these little blushes. I've had, the other ones are MAC, these bigger ones, and Makeup Geek, but the small guys right here, if you can see with this really stormy clouds we got here in Northern Virginia. This is a La Femme blush from Camera Ready Cosmetics. These are $5 or $6 with your discount, and I could not believe that. And the quality of them is so good, you guys. And I just wanted more of a range. I felt like I didn't have enough, and I just had a lot of the same and was really bored with my blushes. So boredom with your makeup kit, it's so real. Z palette, if you guys are looking for an easy way to store your magnetic eyeshadows and blushes, look into one of those, and that's the extra large palette. So good. Then I ventured my way over to Sephora. I've been really bored with my eyebrow routine. I don't know what it is. I've just like felt like I was using MAC Espresso with eyeshadow, and I was just like, no, I need to retire this. This is not doing enough for me. So I went and bought the medium brown powder duo by Anastasia Beverly Hills. I don't know, there's just no one else that does brow products like her. And I was over my dip brow pomade. I was making myself look like angry. Honestly, the gel like was getting too strong. I think the color is too dark for me. I had dark brown. I'm loving medium brown. It's ashy, so it doesn't get too pull too much red. It just does a really good job of keeping me like nice and real. I don't know, I mean, it keeps me natural or full brow, depending on what I want. And then I also got the brow primer because one of my favorite people here on YouTube, Angie D. Batista, I hope I'm saying her name right for as much as I watch her. She is so wonderful. If you guys are a makeup artist, you need to check her out. She has one of the most thorough makeup art. It's like taking a makeup course, like for free, because she gives so much value and information. I'll link her in the description box below. But rub the primer and then brush your hairs through and then put the powder, and it just clings onto it more and just stands out more and does what you want the product to do more. So I'm excited about this and I really like it. I'm creating that like really fun full brow lately and just like kind of more spiky, and I'm liking it. Like what you see on the models and stuff when they have full bushy, like I'm trying to go for that like just woke up type of look, and this took work, but you know, that's what I'm going for, and I'm loving it. And then I did hit up MAC, and I actually went back to my old MAC stomping grounds. If you guys don't know, they have the Back to MAC recycling program, which is where you bring in 6 empty containers. They can't be the wood, anything that's like sharpened and dwindles down, obviously, but anything that's plastic, or that's empty, or even if you just don't want it anymore, they take it back. And 6 of them, you get a free lipstick or a lip gloss, which is so awesome. So I had 18. Which is insane. And I got the lipstick faux, and I actually swatched it for you guys. I swatched all the things I'm gonna show you. I like thought ahead here, and faux is this one. I thought it'd be perfect for bridal lipstick, so I'm gonna somehow have to add that to my nude palette or just keep it out on its own. Then I also got the lipstick mare, which is a matte, and it's a little bit warmer and a little bit richer in color, but I thought these were great bridal shades. And then I need another lip gloss, so I picked up, actually the girl told me to get this, and it's a little scary looking, but actually it's really peachy and beautiful to kind of lighten and brighten any lip shade, because if it gets dark too quickly, you can always lighten it with a gloss that has some tint to it. So this is Myth Lip Gloss, which is a really nice kind of nude that'll just lighten up. It can even go over the lipstick I have right now. I want you guys to also know about the Matte Ink Superstay by Maybelline. I wore these in my last 2 tutorials, and I'm obsessed, you guys. I just can't believe these are drugstore formulas, drugstore quality, that are so high-end to me. And I am obsessed with this color in particular, Ruler, especially for fall. Oh my God, you guys, it's so good. It's number 80. And the applicator, I don't know what, it's like has a hole in it. It's kind of crazy, but it's such a nice fine tip to really create a sharp lip line with no feathering. You can like slap it on, no lip liner, just no fuss. It's kind of one of those like lipstick hacks to like look put together. I just like, you know, do mascara with this and I'm good to go. It just looks really nice. I also love the one Seductress, so I did swatch them for you guys because I want you to see. This is Seductress in the Maybelline Matte Ink. It's that second one. And then this is Ruler right here, which is that really nice berry shade, and I've been posting about it on my Instagram if you guys want to see more pictures of me in them. But highly recommend them, you guys. Like wow, the formula is outstanding. It dries down and then still has like a shine to it, even though it's a liquid lip, and like it's just so long wearing. It's crazy how long wearing it is. This is the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder, and I got it in 2, and which it does not have a lot of shades, I will say, which was disappointing. This is my first Charlotte Tilbury product, and YouTube kind of, it was one of those things that was like told me to buy it in a way. I've seen so many reviews for it, and I'm kind of steering away from baking as much as I can. I still do it, of course, but I notice it's just too drying underneath the eyes for some clients, especially for more mature clients, and I just don't want that. I want their under eyes to look be set but not look dry and cakey, and this is supposed to be amazing. The last makeup thing I'll talk about is MAC Prep and Prime, which I showed on Instagram, and it's a makeup essential for me, whether it's in my kit, whether it's for me. Like, my skin drinks this stuff. It's so good, you guys. A lot of you, I think, wonder like what's the point of this stuff. So what you can do with this is actually hydrate your skin before makeup with it. Like, I'll replace it as moisturizer if I'm in a rush, just quickly mist it on my face. If a client is really dry, I'll do moisturizer and then this, and it gives like such a nice dewy finish. It allows foundation to go on like a dream. You could also spray this on throughout the makeup process, so after you do layer your foundation, concealer, sometimes you notice like things start to get heavy really fast. This is kind of like your your rescue bottle. It'll come in and just calm everything down. Like anytime I feel like I get a little too heavy-handed, I go in with Vicks Bless, a sponge, just kind of calm things down. This is just like my like melatonin. I'm just like, it chills me out. Like I love this stuff and it smells so good. Every time I spray it on someone, they feel like they're getting like a spa treatment. So that's an extra bonus. So yeah, that is it for the makeup side. So if you're still sticking around, which I hope you guys are, because I like to think I have some good fashion items for you guys here. I did go to H&M and I'm so excited. I found some hoops that weren't really expensive. I don't know why people are getting away with charging so much for hoops. They're so simple and people, you know, like lose earrings anyways, and I just can't justify spending that much on a hoop. So I got these from H&M and they came in a set, and now, yes, where are they? They're right here. And you guys, look how amazing and big these are. Like I can get real crazy real fast. I love the variety, but I went for the small ones today and I just think they're really cute. They're really in right now. Hoops are really big. And so it's $6.99. Madewell had the exact same thing for $38. Yeah, just saying. The next thing I got is this really basic camel sweater, but this is what I live in the fall. I work from home. I'm going for comfort. I'm going for, you know, just keeping it real simple, and I love my neutrals. So this one is great. It literally feels like cashmere. $17, like so cheap and easy. I have been eyeing like a jacket like this because everyone's wearing these, and one of my friends who's like amazing with fashion, I did a video on her recently. She was wearing something like this and I was literally walking around H&M like, what would Elle buy? Found this, and it's kind of like a looser one. Once it's on, it kind of pulls in at the waistline, making it really flattering. But I know this is a big trend right now, so I didn't want to commit to like an overly expensive one, but I like it because it's a little bit long. I can wear it with a legging and a white top. I can wear it with high-waisted jeans, and this was $34. So I just thought the value was really good, and I like the way it made me feel in it. I felt like professional, but also like and stylish at the same time. Winner, winner for me. Then I went over to Zara and I really got so excited to see this on a mannequin. And it's, I love leopard so much. It's so hard to find a good print, but they have so much leopard right now, especially online, if you guys take a look. And I was really feeling this dress because I don't have anything this length. This literally goes down to like my calf area. And it's definitely something that's just kind of fun for fall and winter, and it's a 3/4 length, has a little bit of puff on the shoulder, and it's a V-neck, so it's really flattering around the neckline. But the reason I really loved this because it was paired up with a leather jacket, a faux leather jacket in the store. So, and I loved the look of texture with a print and then like ankle booties. I just think that's really nice. Or doing this with like tights when it gets a little colder. I just think this can act as a really good neutral for fall and winter, and I'm like all in. And I definitely spent a little more on this, but I loved it so much, and I haven't been spending a lot on clothes, and I just try to buy key pieces that I think I can interchange in my wardrobe and really use a lot. This is $69 and I just love that. I love the way that one looks and really excited about it. So the next thing I got is this skirt, and I thought this print was amazing, especially for the holiday time. I thought it was beautiful. I thought it had really nice strong pleats, which really give it a beautiful look to it, and just like the movement to it I love. And it's like a midi, I think it would, no, yeah, it goes way past the midi actually, skirt, and I can do it high-waisted with a turtleneck. I just love this for the holidays and for working, just so easy. I'm just kind of over my all black wardrobe for when I work, so I thought adding a few prints here and there is good. Even though I try to stick to my like wardrobe capsule neutrals as much as I can, I just have thought, you know, a few pops for this coming fall and winter season would be fun. And oh my gosh, I've just talked so much. My throat is so dry right now. I hope you guys even stayed again a lot. If you have, like, hats off to you staying around this long. You guys are the best. I really, really hope you guys found some inspiration from this haul. Don't go and spend all your money on everything. Take your time if you're building your kit. You know, figure out what works for you. This is what works for me. If you guys have any questions at all, let me know in the comment section below. Also, what you want to see next. I love to hear. I read all your comments. And I look forward to seeing you all in the next video. As always, take care, guys. Bye.